If you can hear me, can you please type three in the chat box? If you can see me and hear me, is it possible for you guys to type three in the chat boxes?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, wonderful. Thank you so much. So let me take you through a story here. Well, I am a firm believer of everybody having a choice. And so do you at any given point in time. Imagine that it's a late one evening and it's drizzling outside. You are wandering between the work, the pile of work that you have, and a warm, cozy bed back at home. You are in office with your team. All of you just had some pizza to fill your empty stomachs. You and your team have been working all week, loads of hard work to understand how to find a solution to a system bug. Your client is facing that challenge and they have thrown that challenge up to you. And you have gathered all the necessary data, assembled the required information, analyzed everything very, very carefully. You have even spoken to some of the experts to understand how can we solve this. However, you still do not have anything that can help you crack this. On the top of it, you feel that there are certain things or the certain pieces that are missing. And what do? You start worrying, and the team members also do not come together to form a solution or to come to a solution. Now, this is everyday story which replicates in other areas as well. It could be your college project, it could be something at home, where all of you put together as a team are not able to come to consensus and you're not able to find a solution. This happens and it can happen at any time during the day. How many of you are able to relate to this? If you can, please type Y in the chat box. Wonderful, thank you. So you would see that sometimes the choices that we have are easy. That means there are alternatives. There is number one and there's number two. And these are easy alternatives. Have you ever seen that we have it's a very easy thing to choose. So for example, today in the morning, I felt like having breakfast and I was a little confused what to have during the breakfast. I decided I can have a cereal, which is good for my health, or I also had a chocolate donut in my refrigerator and I felt that would be more interesting to eat today. An easy choice. And believe me, most of you will vote for chocolate donut if I'll ask you what would you want to eat in case it's a cereal or it's a donut. So you would hands down go ahead, okay, fine, let's have donut because that's what resonates a lot with you guys, right? So that's what you want to do. You want to eat donut. Easy. Wonderful. Now let's see a hard choice. The hard choice is when the alternatives that you have, number one and number two, they are equally good. This one is not better than this one, and this one isn't better than this. Then at that time, I have had so many of my clients who talk to me and say, "Hey, Rima, you know what? Should I hear what my heart is saying or should I hear what my mind is saying?" And it is indeed so common with all of us that we are generally divided between our heart and mind, and several times we feel, "What exactly do I go for?" Now, let's take something for an example. For example, the career choices. Let's say the career choice is between a graphic designer and an investment banking profile. When I say that, a graphic designer is a creative person. He has a creativity which is engraved in him and he wants to exploit that. And the cons are that the graphic designer, the pay is relatively less as compared to an investment banking profile. Now let's go to the investment banking profile. Here you can manipulate money. here you can make a lot of money. But does that mean an investment banking profile is better than a graphical designer profile or a graphic designer profile? It's very difficult to choose right out of college when people think which one to choose. Let's make the investment banking profile a little better. Let's add some more money, what investment banker would take home. When we add more money, that means if you actually evaluate, this alternative of investment banking looks better than the first alternative of graphic design. More money, right? Now think from that angle, what if you do become an investment banker in the end, but you suck at it? You aren't really good at it, but you became because you had something which told you to go for investment banking, and that was money. That really doesn't make the investment banking profile better than a graphic designing profile if I am a creative individual. And hence the choice is hard. I'll pause here for a minute and try and understand from you all, if you could tell me that in case you have a hard choice, what is the first thing that you would do? Let me call out a few individuals here who can help me. I can see Sonali here. Sonali? Can you please come online? Is it possible, Ipshita and Captain Shekhar, for somebody to speak to me? Can they go off mute and speak to me?
Yes, they can talk to you. They can simply unmute and they can talk.
They can, right?
Yes,
right.
Yes, of course.
Yeah, I had Sonali here. I don't know where is she right now. Rahul? All right, I think these guys are on mute. Ipshita, I think you heard me correct. So why don't you help me understand that in case you have a hard choice to make and you are not sure which alternative is better, what would you do?
Well, in that case, I would compare the alternatives and choose which is the better, like the pros and cons of the alternatives. And then I'll make a decision based on that.
All right. A lot of times, as I told you, evaluating the pros and cons also doesn't make one alternative better than the other. Sometimes the alternatives are supposed to be the way they are. As I told you that investment banking will give you more, it will give you more money as compared to a graphic designing profile. But is it that you would want to go for it because you don't know how would you, you are a creative person. You would want to stick to something which is, even if it is paying less, but that's the right choice to make. However, when the decisions are difficult to take, what do? We take an easy option. Let me tell you a story about myself.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, the question which you asked to me right now, the answer which I said, deciding upon the best alternative, counting the pros and the cons. So in the case of choosing the career option, which you gave the example of graphic designer and investment banker. So yes, in that case, I actually meant that if I'm a passionate creative person, if I'm passionate about graphic designing, so in this case, the pros and the cons which I will decide between is actually it will be related to the graphic designing field which I want to pursue. So if I am thinking about the pros, so I will be counting the pros if I get when I will be choosing graphic designing as my career option. If I am passionate about it, so passion will be one of the pros. Then interest will be another pros. Yeah, the salary, the compensation part, it might of course differ, but that will not play a very major role if I compare it to my passion and everything.
I completely agree with you. There are a few things which can be used as the pointers to do the to draw between two Okay. So let's see, for example, graphic designing and investment banking. Now, when you're sitting and comparing, there are a few things which you can relate to, and you can actually decide the pros and cons on the basis of that. So for example, you have two identical luggage, okay, two identical suitcases. And I ask you, which one is heavier than the other, right? What would you do? There are three parameters to judge it on. One, it can be equal, one can be less than the other, or it can be more than the other. So real numbers are comparable. There are a few things basis which you can never compare. And that is what the passion, right? That takes precedence over everything else. However, when it comes to money, you can actually sit and decide, okay, this is where the pros are, this is where the cons are. Well, I completely agree with you, Ipshita. A lot of people think rationally and they decide basis their passion. But majority of people in the industry today, or people who are or students who are aspiring ones and want to get into the industry, they decide basis the money. That is something, and as I said, maybe they will pick up an investment banking job and they really not like it. And after some time, they would want to probably go back and explore the creativity that they have and become a graphic designer, or maybe do that part time. But yes, that's something that I personally feel that in case you need a different result, then you have to take a different decision right in the beginning.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, the question which you asked, this was very much related to me personally. Because the reason being is, if I talk about myself, then I am very much passionate about the HR field. So, Okay. Yeah, during my graduation also, I took a lot of keen interest in the field of HR. I did internships on HR, and here when I'm doing my PGDM also, I did my PGDM, so there also, and in air crews also, I'm into HR. So that's why, and if I talk about work, then yes, I have a dual specialization, that is in HR and marketing both. But the reason I want to pursue, even in this situation of pandemic, where the job for HRs are becoming very difficult, there are a lot of changes that are actually taking place. So even in this case also, I am very much concerned about my passion rather than the compensation.
Well, on that, Ipshita, on that note, let me share a quick thing with you, which of course would help you. Cognizant has a future innovation lab. Okay. Now, what do they do is they do a lot of study on the future roles that might come in, and they have done extensive study in the HR space. Their papers are out there on their website also. You can download them, and they would tell you what kind of HR roles can come in next 10 years. So that's going to be the innovation later. Now, again, coming back to the topic, it's on you to choose to go there and download that and go through it and understand what's installed later for the HR professionals. But at the same time, you can just choose to be at the way the river is flowing and just flow with it. So we'll see how it will evaluate, but it will evolve, but it actually is there out there. So go through that document. It is very much there on Cognizant's portal.
Sure, ma'am. Sure.
Yeah. All right. Wonderful. So today, continuing on our story, the decision process that Ipshita, you and I were discussing right now, it has started becoming a lot harder these days. And the reason is because of the amount of data that we need to consider. So when we are discussing, you and I discussed, it was for guys who have joined us recently, Ipshita and I were discussing about the hard choices and the easy choices, while the pros and cons we evaluated were basis the real numbers and also basis certain other parameters which could not be evaluated in terms of equal, less or more. The decisions in certain projects or in not in the real life scenarios as such personally, but when it comes to large projects or certain certain programs that you're working on, there is to come to consensus along with the team members on a particular thing becomes difficult because everybody has their own viewpoint and everybody has to analyze a lot of data that they need to consider. So when I say that, I asked my son, I asked him, do you want an ice cream? And he said, yes. He said, I want a gelato. He said, he gave me the description, a dark chocolate, something like a Madagascar in a waffle cone, topped with some other chocolate and sprinkles of chocolate, etc. I was like amazed. I said, okay, there's a lot of data to process. I went back in my days and I started thinking, if my dad would have asked me, Reema, do you want an ice cream? And I would have said yes. This is where we are, and that is a huge difference, right? I mean, I would have said, yes, I need an ice cream. And today my son says, I need an ice cream, however, with all this stuff, because that's so much of data is available for him to process and design something in his mind that he wants to grab today. Also, I was talking to a data analytics guy some time back. I asked him, what makes you so passionate about what you are doing currently? He said, Reema, try and imagine that a flight takes off. And the flight lands at the destination. What happens in the mid is, if you really sit and evaluate the data, there will be close to 1 million data points to go through. Now that's humongous amount of data. That is the power of data that you have. And when you actually try, sit, evaluate, basis what the tools, techniques, and the data that's available, the decision becomes much harder. Let's see, give me a minute. Is it that somebody is typing something for me? All right. Yeah, so let me just close this. Okay. All right, so let's think about the tools and the techniques that we are using to analyze the data these days. It's hilarious, but I'll share another story. I have a lot of stories to share. Of course, you will give me the credit that I come with so much of experience and I deal with variety of individuals everyday basis. So I have a client who needed some vice presidents for a particular role. I got in touch with this gentleman who was in the US. He's a returning Indian. He wanted to come back to India. We started exploring this position of vice president with my client for him before the pandemic hit us all. And the process got delayed. This gentleman finally lost his job in US and he was desperate to come back to India. I pushed his case and I made a case and I told my client, this guy is definitely going to take the offer. He'll come on board. Now talk about the tools and techniques. Now this guy is a quantitative research guy. He has read all the possible books on quants, on stochastic calculus, and you name it all, everything. He applied all these techniques on his personal life, and I quote, what did he say? He said, I applied Monte Carlo simulation on this offer, and I feel that I can stay back in the US because another offer is around the corner. He did not take the offer, which was at a vice president level, a level up for him, more money for him. And of course, he used something which was a stochastic technique on his personal life and he decided against it. Now, there is something else that you guys can see that I mentioned here in the slide, which is called as the divergent views amongst the team members. Anytime, whenever we decide any kind of offsite for our team, everybody has a different place that they want to go to. Somebody would say that let's go to a nature reserve. Somebody would say let's go to Goa. Somebody would say let's go to something where there is a mountain, where there are mountains. We all want to go there and enjoy. However, they all decide eventually where they want to go and everybody ends up going to Goa. However, during the entire process, there are so many different views that you'll come across. Another thing which is very, very important to consider is the oversimplification of the information. It's a very simple example. If you are coughing, if you're sneezing, if you have temperature, if you have headache, go to Google and it will give you the answer that it could possibly be cancer. So it's oversimplification, as is. What you must remember is the tools and the techniques and the data, and all of these in themselves, they need you to use them to come to certain judgment. It eventually helps you make the hard choices. I will take you to the next slide, guys, now. Give me a quick minute. Before I take you there, something is called as a gray area. Now, gray area is something where you have the tools, the techniques, the data, you have evaluated everything, but you are still not able to make any choice. I have come across several gray spaces, so many of them, while helping the people find the jobs. I felt nice about the fact that I got to earn a living by helping people. But I heard somebody said this to me the other day, that I don't want to be a businessman claiming to also be a decent human being, but I want to be a decent human being who carries out business. Well, this is what you need to appreciate in the journey more and more, especially when you are faced with these gray choices, the areas. Trust me, you will grow if you will feel that way. You must be able to make choices without bypassing the core obligation of being a decent human being. Now, there are a few things that you need to keep in mind, and I know that we are close to our... This is the last slide, of course, from my side. So what you need to understand is you need to put yourself in somebody else's shoes when you're taking a decision or you're dealing with a choice. The ideal choice would be, if the choice is hateful to you, it would be hateful for somebody else as well. Put yourself in their shoes and understand, would this be the right thing to do? You can ask any of your friends or family members or anybody that you trust to do a role play with you. That means you can ask the person to be the other side and take the decision, go out, have a discussion. If the person can play the role really well and the person can open up to you, he can give you exactly what he felt or he or she felt. That will give you the exact result of the choice that you're going to be making. Think about it. Before you take a decision, think about it. Another thing is, you are a human being and you have certain obligations and you cannot dilute them under any circumstances. Let me tell you, I make a few choices every day. I try and do my best to ensure that these are the best decisions that I make under circumstances in which I make these decisions. The choices are several, but I go with the one where I do not get into this decision fatigue, that the decision was wrong. I am not 100% all the time, but I try to be. I try and go back to these 4 points again and again, and I think whether the choice that I'm making should not hurt anybody. You cannot keep everyone happy. There are times when you have to take certain decisions based on certain parameters, but it cannot be so difficult that the other person, you are hurting somebody and you're making the money out of it. I remember having heard Ratan Tata during an interview, when he said that when he was trying to build the Tata Nano factory in Singur, in West Bengal. So that was the time when he said, I'm sorry, I'm going to refer to this note because I want to make sure that I quote exactly what Ratan Tata said. He said, if you put a gun to my head and ask me to decide, then you have to either pull the trigger or remove the gun. What he probably meant was the choice is on the other party to pull the trigger or remove the gun, because he was not willing to go against the core principles and make choices. So before we jump on to the question and answers, I would like to quickly take a moment, guys, here to thank Harvard Business Reviews, from where I have gained these insights and various aspects, and some of which I have touched upon in my session today. Let's see if I have any questions, and I'm happy to take them. Now, guys.
Guys, if you have any question, then you can ask it either in the chat box, or you can switch on your mic and directly ask to ma'am.
Can you read some questions already given? Already they are in the chat box.
Yes, I have one from Neha. She says, ma'am, I want to say that choices are not always in your side and as per your interest, but it might be better for you if you started working hard for it, because whatever is happening, happening for good, she says. I'm a positive kind of person, so I think this may be to satisfy myself. Do you agree, ma'am? Okay. Neha, to a certain extent, I do. You, of course, would take decisions basis what brings you happiness. But whatever choices you are making, make sure that you're putting the people who are involved in that decision-making process in your perspective before you actually make that decision. Happiness alone for you and would mean the best thing, that if everybody agrees to it. But in case it's not hurting anybody, and if you're able to bring in the best for yourself and it's happening for you and which brings happiness to you, of course, I agree with you. That's the best thing that you can do. There are times when you actually, the choices are limited and you would want to pick up the one which brings happiness to you. And as I said, that's an easy choice to make. You have to put everybody involved in that. Faces your decision, if anybody is getting impacted, you need to consider that perspective before you take the decision, is what I said. To a certain extent, I do.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Okay, ma'am, we have one more question from Vaishali Chakravarti. She is asking, what is the role of opportunity cost in case of any sort of decision making? How do I identify that?
Okay, well, Vaishali, you will have to please explain to me what you really mean by opportunity cost.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi, ma'am. So basically, in this case, by opportunity cost, I meant that suppose I'm having two alternatives with me or two choices with me, and for choice two, I'll have to let go of something which is really very important for me, maybe in the long term, but not maybe for now. So how do I understand that I should let it go, or I should take this sort of risk or not, or maybe just, go with the short-term things that I'm getting in my life? So how do I actually decide on that particular thing?
Right, as I told you, Vaishali, right? It's a hard choice. So generally what people do is they look at a short-term gain, and then they realize that this is not something that they were supposed to do, because in the long run, it is something that is going to come back and haunt you. So as Ipshita and I were discussing, there are certain things that you can evaluate basis the real numbers, like equal, minus, less, more. But there are certain other aspects that cannot be, measured. So you have to take the decision basis all the parameters. It can just not be those three. If something is at par, if something is equally important for you, both the sides, both the alternatives, then you have to sit and dwell over it as to in future, what is the best option that you can choose. If your decision today is short term, then you will definitely come back to this question after some time and then start regretting, as this is something that I should have done right in the beginning. So that's where I would leave it up to you. You will have to, or anybody as a matter of fact, if the choices are hard, you have to evaluate basis, other parameters, and not only basis of three that I told you as the real numbers that they are.
Okay.
Was I able to answer your question, Vaishali?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
I have a question, actually.
Yes.
Question is, basically, sometimes what happens is, it has generally happened in everyone's life, I guess, that we no, we do not actually can decide what, sometimes we are very much confused about what we want or what we should decide that about that thing. But sometimes what happens is when someone asks for suggestions, for advice, like to be our best friend or anybody, people closer to us. So in that case, we are very much free to advise them. We understand their situation very easily. But in case of our own situation, this may not happen. So in that case, what will be your suggestion to overcome with this problem?
Generally, Ipshita, you will see that our thoughts are already clogged. When it comes to us, we are not open-minded enough because we are already confused. We have a choice to make. If somebody else is asking for an advice, you understand the problem and you feel this is the right thing to do, and you go ahead and advise the person to do that. You might sometimes also come across individuals who have not taken your advice, but they have done something else because they are listening. They are divided between their mind and their heart. When it comes to you, you need to... So, okay, to answer your question, the first one, when it comes to somebody else asking you for your advice, you can freely give it because this is not something that's impacting you. The thought process is limited. You understand, you give it to her. Now it's her choice whether she wants to implement it or she doesn't want to implement it. And you will not never go back and question her. However, there are times when your friend will come back, I'm going to be saying this in Hindi. Dekh maine teri baat mani na, now I'm in a shit. It's like, yeah, dude, you could have chosen something else. This was just an advice. I didn't actually pull you to take this or do this, right? But when it comes to ourselves, we are more careful. And I would recommend that when it comes to you, it's the best decision maker is you yourself. Discussing it with 10 different people will give you 10 different perspectives. And that means there's more data to evaluate. I think you are the best judge. You know, if you are making a mistake, if a decision is wrong, there's nobody else to blame but yourself. And then there is a room for improvement. It's very easy. It's human nature to put it on somebody else. Yaar, teri baat mani thi. Right? But then I think when it comes to us, taking calculated decision is on us. And we all are intelligent enough to take our decisions. We need not have a clogged mindset when we sit down with our problems, jotting down the pros and cons. We know exactly what we want. It's just this, we are looking for approval.
Yes, ma'am.
And we are looking for approval from ourselves, not from anybody else. Yeah, that's that. I hope I was able to answer your question.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, anybody else wants to ask any question?
Are we good or do we have any questions?
Guys, please speak up. If you have any questions, you can ask to ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am. Vishali here.
Yeah, Vishali.
I have one last question. I mean, I think I'm not. So basically, talking about the parameters is, for example, this global pandemic for us wasn't very sudden and unwanted, maybe a thing that is occurred, and of course it's playing a very important parameter for our decisions, because what I think that maybe before this pandemic I had some things in mind, okay, and now I'm going to do my MBA, then after that I'm going to do this, I'm going to apply for this company, but then this particular thing happened and all the decisions were like, it messed up completely all our decisions to a certain extent. So in that particular situation, I mean, what do you feel that a person should, how to, get everything back in position, maybe not 100%, but maybe 60-70%, like how to start, aligning back those goals again, so that I can work towards my career and work towards the dreams that I've seen, which may have shattered for some moments because of this, pandemic. So what do you think there might be a way, and what do you think, what should I do, or how should I align those goals again?
Okay, well, Vishali, you said it right. And I really would want to stick to a word that you used during when you asked me this question. You had dreams, right?
Yeah.
There are things that happen. This pandemic has happened to everybody.
Yeah.
Nobody was anticipating this. But since your dreams are your dreams, pursue them no matter what. And again, you are asking me how you can align your dreams basis to 60-70% basis the current pandemic. This pandemic is here to stay. Things will come back to normal. Your dreams would not change because of this pandemic, because if you dreamt of doing something, it's still going to be the same. Things will come back to normal. They have to come back to normal. This will just be a part of our lives. But again, it's a decision that you have to take. You can turn things around for yourself, but you have to chase your dreams. That's sacrosanct, because that is something that will bring happiness to you. That is something that will be long-term for you. This, I mean, everybody's got impacted because of this pandemic, if you see. You, I, as a matter of fact, my kids' studies as well. All of us, right? My kid wanted to do a lot of things during his 10th standard, and he wanted to learn coding, etc. The thing's gone for a toss because he's doing online classes the entire day. He doesn't want to again enroll for a course where he's doing another coding. He doesn't want to. However, things obviously will become normal after some time. After he gives his 10th, he would pursue them. So he has time. If time is your enemy right now, my dear, then I think you need to go back and evaluate again the choices that you have right now. The decisions that you have to make are based on the choices that you have. Evaluate those choices. Sit with pen and paper. Draw your pros and cons. And you would know which one is the right one to choose.
I mean, you're talking about some kind of SWOT analysis on the basis of the situation, like about me and my goals.
I wouldn't say SWOT analysis. I would just simplify it basis what exactly you wanted to do. How has that got impacted today? What are the different avenues available for you? You need to evaluate everything. See, I don't really know the core of the issue or the core of the problem. And hence, I can only give you as much information, or I can only guide you as much, because if we are discussing one-on-one on a particular specific problem, then I can get you or give you more insights about it. But if it is that you wish to do something and it has got impacted because of the pandemic, then go back and evaluate the options that you have, the choices that you have.
Okay, well, maybe sometime, ma'am, we can connect and we can discuss few things if possible.
Absolutely. My email ID is reflecting. Is there on the screen? If you wish to write to me, you can.
Sure. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Most welcome.
Okay, ma'am, I would request Poonam to proceed with the vote of thanks.
Thank you, ma'am. The best and the beautiful thing in the world cannot be seen or touched. They must be felt by heart. Thank you is one such prayer amongst them. I considered it a privilege to propose a vote of thanks on the behalf of Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited and the entire team. A very hearty note of thanks to our guest, Mrs. Reema Maheshwari, for gracing your important work and sharing with us. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you for choosing to spend time with me here. Remember, you always have a choice and listen to your heart is what I generally feel. But of course, you can listen to your mind too. Thank you, guys. This is Reema signing.